Well, there was one day of peace around here, but I see it's back. So let me help. I'm going to do another practice walk before we actually get started today, if God willing, we're going to get it started. But I got to add this real quick. You know, I'm just not the kind of person that says anything nice about somebody that ain't nice, whether live or dead. Or if they were mean in this life, then that's the impression they left me with, and that's the one I keep. So this is just a little bit of information for the one who needs it. Don't worry about, you know, when people pass away, die, it's usually family that buries them, or, you know, pays for the service and takes care of everything. So I just want to let them know that they don't have to worry about that unless somebody comes along that wants to do that for them. And I give you my word, I will not say anything nice or say anything positive. Not now and not ever. I don't believe you don't have to worry about that. And I don't think you need to be telling people what you are demanding, that they come and read something at your funeral. I don't really see that happening either. First of all, you don't tell people what to say. Usually you take care of that while you're here. You know, it's kind of by your personality, your actions, who you are. That's kind of what's said. But I don't think you need to worry about that. Normally, in your situation, it'll be taken over by the state. And I don't believe they're going to read anything, or, you know, they might say something over you. But California, I don't know if they'll say a prayer or not. So don't worry about that. And it's amazing to me that you're doing this little speech here about, you know, you said something kind about somebody who passed away, and the videos that you've done, you've trashed the person that cared about you after she died. You just, you know, tore up her memory and something terrible, and she was good to you. So if I got this straight, you talk real kindly, and you'll go out of your way to steal and, you know, to pay for them to have a wonderful service and headstone. And the ones that were so good to you, and the ones that you, them are the ones you talk so terribly about. But just keep in mind, I'm not like, you know, the ones before me. And, you know, I was always taught, if you had nothing to say nice, just don't say anything. But that's really not me. You know, I've always been one that kind of beat a different drum anyhow. So I'll say what kind of person you are now and then too. That's if I know, and I'm sure I will know, because you'll quit getting on here acting a fool for long enough for somebody to check into it. Well, I'm gonna stop. Oh, and one more thing. Let me just help you out a little bit. I'm gonna put this. This is gonna be at the end, because if you don't want your, you know, you sniff all the time, and it's so annoying. And I just, every time, I just want to tell you, blow your nose. Just get up and blow your nose. Get tissue, blow your nose, blow your nose, blow your nose. It's not good to sit around and suck up all that snot. It's just not good for your sinuses or your head or anything else. So you need to put this on like a replay, so you hear it every few seconds. And for anybody who's going through that phase, you know, when children are small, they have a tendency to, they're letting it run out of their nose, and then they'll suck it up. And then you start, you usually get the tissue and blow the nose. I don't know what happened with this one, but you do constantly say, go blow your nose, until it just gets in them and they grow up and blow the nose. You know, I'm sounding a little stuffy right now, but I promise I'm going to blow my nose. I'm not going to sniff or be disgusting about it. But that, I really wanted to put that out there at the end, you know, blow your nose. Blow your nose. Just keep replaying it. Blow your nose.